Hi, good evening everyone. So I think you all attended for Angular. Right, let us see what is this Angular. We already know that Angular is a client-side TypeScript framework which is used to develop dynamic web applications. Angular is a product of Google, which is used to Angular is a TypeScript framework, you can tell. Is it clear? Angular is a TypeScript framework, is a TypeScript framework which is used to develop, which is used to develop dynamic web applications, dynamic web applications that will run on browser and mobiles, that will run on browser and different other devices and mobile also. Okay, now the TypeScript framework. What is a TypeScript actually? TypeScript is a programming language. TypeScript is a programming language. So what is the prerequisite to learn Angular? First of all, you must have the knowledge on UI technologies like HTML, JavaScript, is it clear? Plus CSS. JavaScript is not mandatory. JavaScript is optional. If you have JavaScript knowledge, it is good. If you don't have also, no problem. Monday, I'm starting UI technologies. Wednesday, I'm starting new batch, free batch, morning 11:30. If anybody are interested, you can attend that class. Okay, now, here UI technologies means HTML, JavaScript and CSS. HTML main purpose is to display the data on browser. If you want to display the data on the browser, you have to take the support of what? HTML in a proper format. JavaScript main purpose is to perform client-side activities. By using JavaScript, we can perform client-side activities like validations, effects, event handling, all these things we can do with JavaScript. CSS purpose is to apply what? Styles. Styles means appearance, look and feel. If you want to apply any styles, you have to apply, go for CSS. As I already discussed that whenever you develop any web application, you have to deploy that application on the server so that multiple users can access that application via browser and internet. In olden days, these web applications are developed by using Java, .NET, PHP, etc. If you develop any application by using these server-side technologies, mostly the code will execute on server. 70% of code will execute on server, just 30% of code will execute on browser. Because of that, unnecessarily button on server is increased. Performance issues can. So the solution for all these things is JavaScript. What is the beautiness of JavaScript is, JavaScript will execute the code on where? Browser. So slowly demand for JavaScript is gradually increased. But the developers, web application developers like Java, .NET, PHP, Python, these all developers felt very difficult to work with JavaScript. So Microsoft released one language, that is TypeScript. So TypeScript is a programming language, JavaScript is a scripting language. Is it clear? So first we have to learn TypeScript, then Angular. Angular was a framework. Angular is a framework that was developed. Angular is a framework that was developed by using TypeScript. By using what? TypeScript. So what is a framework? Framework is a software which is used to develop the applications fastly and efficiently within less amount of time. Frameworks are developed by taking the support of programming languages. So TypeScript is a programming language. Angular is a framework. Okay. So first of all, in order to learn Angular, first of all, you have to learn what? TypeScript. So let us see what are the syllabus of TypeScript. Generally, what is a language? If you want to learn any language, language is generally used to create the communication. Generally, natural language, if two persons wants to communicate with each other, some natural language is required, some English or Hindi or Telugu, like that. If a person want to communicate with animal, like dogs or monkeys, what is required? Body language. Through some symbols, signals, we can communicate. If a person want to communicate with a machine or any computer, then programming language is required. Whenever you learn any programming language, every programming language will have three things. Programming language or scripting language, whatever it may be you learn, every language will have three things will be there. One is rules will be there, Other one is syntax will be there. Another one is concepts will be there. Another one is logics will be there. Any language you learn, every language will have four things will be there. One is rules. Other one is syntax. Another one is concepts. Other one is logics. You learn any language, whether Java, .NET, Python, TypeScript, anything. TypeScript is also a language. From one language to another language, rules will change, syntax will change. Concepts and logics will not change. Syllabus is same. Whatever the language you learn, syllabus is same. Only rules will change, syntax will change. So before learning Angular, first of all, we have to start learning TypeScript. And TypeScript is a programming language. Angular is very high-end framework. Okay. So always try to by heart the rules and syntaxes, understand the concepts, apply with the support of basic mathematics, you have to apply the logics. So your TypeScript syllabus, how to learn TypeScript means, first of all, I'll write the syllabus. Some here operators. Similarly, here we'll declare about variables. We will learn syllabus I'm writing. Data types. Okay, now. Similarly, here we are writing some conditional statements. Conditional statements. Similarly, we'll discuss loops. Similarly, we'll discuss arrays. We'll discuss OOPs, very powerful. OOPs is, JavaScript does not support OOPs. It supports only objects. It will not support classes, polymorphism, inheritance. These principles it will not support. TypeScript will support all the principles. Operators, variables, data types, conditional statements, loops, arrays, collections, OOPs, all principles it will support. Abstraction, encapsulation, okay, na? Abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, okay, na? And other extra concepts in OOPs like interfaces, abstract classes, all these things we'll cover. Collections, generics, we'll discuss nowadays generics and collections. Generics are very powerful, generics, and we'll discuss about lambda expressions. I'm telling the syllabus actually. Okay, now. And here one more point, TypeScript, is it clear? TypeScript supports two types of programming. TypeScript supports two types of programming actually. One is functional programming. Other one is object-oriented programming. Nowadays it is a fashion actually. In olden days, if you worked with Java supports only object-oriented programming. Java is a programming language, object-oriented programming language. C#.NET is also object-oriented programming language. But coming to Python, you can use Python in two ways. One is you can use Python like a functional programming as well as object-oriented programming also. Similarly, TypeScript also you can use in two ways. One is functional programming, other one is object-oriented programming. Functional programming means just dealing with functions, declaring functions, communication with operations. Function is used to perform a specific operation. Okay, now. Python, that's why Python, who will use Python means Python can be used in two ways. One is you can use Python like a scripting. Other one is you can use Python like web application development. If you want to use Python, if you want to develop total web application by using Python, you have to learn Django, Python, ORM, etc. There OOPs is required. But if you use Python like a testing, like DevOps, AWS, or some other third party Hadoop, some data science, machine learning, they will use Python mostly like scripting. Similarly, TypeScript also designed in such a manner. TypeScript also supports two types of programming. One is functional programming, other one is object-oriented programming. Functional programming means just declare the function, function name, bracket open, bracket close. Okay, na? Here you can declare some variable, int x is equal to 10. Sorry, in TypeScript you can declare the variable like this, x colon number is equal to 10, and here you can print console.log of print the x. This is functional programming, simple programming. Object-oriented programming means what? Here you have to declare class, here I will declare some employee. Here I'll declare some variables. S number colon number semicolon, and here I'll try to declare S name colon string, something like this. You have to declare classes. Age colon number. Okay, now this is your class, and you can create object also. What is this object, class, and everything? I'll explain you. Don't worry. S1 colon student is equal to new student of something like this. This is object oriented programming. Object oriented programming, everything you declare inside the class only. Class level programming. Functional programming, everything you represent in the form of functions. Mostly testing point of view, mobile testing or any other testing point of view or scripting point of view, we'll use functional programming. So your Java.NET supports object oriented programming. Whatever you want to write, you have to write inside the class only. You cannot declare the code outside the class. C language is supports structural programming. So nowadays languages recently they are introduced like TypeScript or Python. These supports both functional programming and object oriented programming, because nowadays the data is totally changed. Nowadays streaming data is very popular. Streaming data means what? Continuous flow of data. In olden days, from past 10 years or 15 years, people are depending on relational databases. SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, they will store the data in the form of table, collection of rows and columns. But nowadays the total style is changed. Streaming data, continuous flow of data. If you order any food in Swiggy, the Swiggy delivery boy will go to the restaurant. You can track his details through your mobile. Okay, now that is continuous flow of data. So functional programming is very suitable to work on streaming data like Python or TypeScript. Did you understand? Can you hear me, everyone? Can you hear me? Can you hear my voice? Please respond in the chat box. Yes. Yes. So if you want to call the function, you can call F1 of something like this. Function will get executed when we call it. In future, we'll discuss about functional programming. You don't worry. Just here I'm explaining that TypeScript supports both functional programming as well as object-oriented programming. But see what I'm doing here. We are learning Angular. What is Angular? Angular is a framework. Angular is a framework which is used to develop dynamic web applications. So Angular will use object oriented features of TypeScript. Is it clear? If you are Angular, TypeScript is not only used for Angular, for other development also we can use TypeScript. Some testing, some working on streaming data. It was designed in such a manner. It is a product of Microsoft. But you all came here to learn Angular. So Angular will use TypeScript. What features of TypeScript is used by Angular means object-oriented principles. So you must have the knowledge on OOPs. Are you following, everyone? So what is the syllabus of TypeScript we are discussing? We are discussing about operators, variables, data types, conditional statements, loops, arrays, and here we'll discuss about functional programming. We'll discuss initially. We'll discuss about functional programming. Later we'll discuss about object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming means what? Multiple users can communicate with single application at a time. If you take Gmail, Gmail is a web application, and that web application is kept on where? Server. So how many people will open Gmail at a time? One after other, all at a time. All at a time. Multiple users will connect to the server at a time to access that application. So for every user, a separate object is created. 100 users means 100 objects. How many application? One application. Where is that application? Server. How many users are accessing the application? If you take a Gmail application, where is that Gmail application kept? Server. So how many people will access that application? Multiple users will access that application. 100 users means 100 browsers. So all these users communicating with server. For every user, what is created? A separate object is created. Means here what I'm telling means multiple users are accessing the application at a time. That is possible only with the support of what? OOPs. Web application development. It is possible only with the support of what? OOPs. Yes or no? So in Angular, you must be expert in OOPs actually. Many people will learn OOPs with real world, but try to learn OOPs with real time. Did you understand, everyone? Can you hear my voice? Clear? My voice is clear. Sandeep wants to check. Once again, ask him to again join the class. Yes, that's fine. Okay, these all are the concepts: operators, variables, data types, conditional statements, loops, arrays, functional programming, OOPs, collections and generics, lambda expressions. Okay, these are all the concepts what we are learning in TypeScript. In OOPs, lot of other topics are there, passing the data. And here one more powerful points are callback functions. Very powerful topic in Angular is callback functions. And we must have the knowledge on design patterns, very powerful. In this design pattern in TypeScript, you must have the knowledge on singleton design pattern. Similarly, factory design pattern. Similarly, dependency injection. It is also very, very powerful topic. I will write dependency injection as separately. Dependency injection. We have to learn dependency injection. Is it clear? Nowadays, it is a fashion actually. For all the languages supports dependency injection. Okay, design patterns we will learn. Operators, variables, data types, conditional statements, loops, arrays. In OOPs, we will learn all the things, class, object, interfaces, overloading, overriding, multiple inheritance, different varieties, polymorphism, all that exception handling also we have to learn actually. Here I will try to write one more topic. Like this maximum I will try to cover. You have to learn like a language only. Is it clear? TypeScript is a programming language. Angular is very high-end framework. High-end framework. If you are from Java background, it is like Core Java and Spring Boot. In middle, no need of JSP, servlets, JDBC, these all are not required. That type of connectivity is there between TypeScript and Angular. If you are from .NET, it is something like C#.NET with .NET Core. In middle, no need to travel. One small language, one powerful language, and one high-end framework. TypeScript is a programming language developed by Microsoft. Angular is a framework developed by Google by taking the support of TypeScript. Collaboration is there. Nowadays, very hot cake in the market, Angular. Okay, Microsoft is also releasing one new framework, Blazor. It is a competitor for Angular actually, making C#.NET code to execute directly on browser, similar like Angular. But now still, now the current market is web application developer means 100% you must have the knowledge on Angular and React. First, Angular is mandatory. React.js is a library product of Google, Facebook. Angular is a framework. React is a library. Developed by Facebook. React will not use TypeScript again. Again, you have to use ES6, something like JavaScript, advanced JavaScript. It will support any OOPs. Okay, na? Very, very easy. Which one? TypeScript. If you are from any other programming background, like Java, .NET or Python, concepts are same. Only the syntax will change. You don't worry, again I will teach the complete TypeScript from basics. I will teach again. You no need to have any knowledge on TypeScript or JavaScript. HTML minimum knowledge is enough. If you want HTML, just go to YouTube and type HTML by Kannababu and you can watch that videos. If anybody don't have the knowledge, our next coming Wednesday I'm conducting free UI technologies batch at morning 11:30 a.m. Okay, you can attend that batch also. 20 days classes. I will take separate classes for HTML, JavaScript and CSS, HTML5. Did you understand everyone? This is about TypeScript. Okay, na? Did you got clarity? What is TypeScript? TypeScript is a programming language. Now we have to discuss about Angular. So here, in Angular, what we'll discuss about? First, after completion of TypeScript only, I will start Angular. All these things we have to discuss first TypeScript. After that, we'll start Angular. In Angular, first we'll discuss about introduction. Is it clear? Introduction to web technologies. Introduction means everything will come. Why Angular? What is Angular? All these things. And then installation. Installation is very, very difficult actually. You have to install a lot of softwares while working with Angular. You have to install TypeScript. You have to install Node.js. You have to install Visual Studio Code. Okay, now you have to install NPM. Is it clear? A lot of setup is required. Still, is it clear? I'll give you clarity on that. You don't worry. Yes or no? First of all, we will learn introduction and then installation of Angular, and then we'll try to discuss about Angular CLI. Here we'll discuss about Node.js, similarly npm, similarly Angular commands, Angular CLI. All these things we'll try to discuss. Installation only it will come actually. Is it clear? And Visual Studio Code. We'll discuss about all these things, npm, all these things we'll discuss, and then we'll discuss about architecture of Angular. I'm telling you just the syllabus actually, just I'll write the rough syllabus, okay? And here in Angular is a component based architecture. Here we'll discuss about modules, and then we'll discuss about components, and then we'll discuss about services, and then we'll discuss about directives. And then we'll discuss about inbuilt dependency injection by Angular framework. Angular framework only will do dependency injection. How it will do, we'll discuss. And then we'll discuss about data binding. Data binding in Angular we'll discuss. Different types of data binding is there. And then we'll discuss about pipes in Angular. And then we'll discuss about structural directives. Already we covered, I think, directives. And then we'll discuss about passing data, parent and child components, communication between different components. You can write communication between different components in Angular. This is a component based architecture, no? Different components. And then we'll discuss about single page applications, SPA, how to develop single page applications in Angular. And we'll discuss about JSON server, fake APIs. Is it clear? Consuming fake APIs in Angular. And here we'll discuss about web API also, some other restful services, consuming restful services in Angular. All these things we'll discuss. Consuming restful services. Is it clear? And then we'll discuss about passing data between parent and child, passing data between multiple components, okay, na? That we can do with the help of @input and @output. Some decorators are there. We'll discuss about all these things. And here we'll discuss about the emitter, something like event emitter. Is it clear? And here we'll discuss about callback functions in Angular, that is observables. You can also call it as observables as well as subscribers. We'll discuss, or else you can keep as a separate topic. Here you can give observables and a subscribe method in Angular, okay, na? And we'll discuss about single phase application, module to module communication, component to component communication, module to module communication, okay, na? And then we'll discuss about router guard in Angular. And we'll discuss about router guard in Angular. Angular material we'll discuss actually. Okay, here we'll discuss about Angular material. It is also a very beautiful topic. Okay, and then we'll discuss about providers. Lot of other topics are there. That are, anyway, it will cover in module section actually. Okay, na? And any other high-end topics are there. We'll discuss about unit testing in Angular. How to do unit testing in Angular. And here we'll cover about interceptors in Angular. All these topics we'll try to cover. And finally, in any additional features, new features, is it clear? We'll discuss. And then we'll develop a real-time project also. One complete real-time project we'll develop. Real-time project in Angular with Angular 10. Is it clear? With Angular. And then we'll discuss about resume preparation. And then we'll discuss about interview questions. Okay, na? Before this, I will try to give some MongoDB introduction also. I will try to explain MongoDB. One small task with mean stack also. Just one at the end, I will cover one mean stack. Just one. So on CRUD operations with mean. CRUD. Is it clear with mean? MongoDB, Express.js, Angular, and Node.js actually. So this is the syllabus actually. If any topics are there, we'll add in middle. This is not a problem. Okay. Actually, here we have to discuss about some other powerful topics in Angular, right? Template driven forms. Here we will discuss about template driven forms as well as reactive forms. I forgot actually. Reactive forms in Angular we have to discuss. And then we have to discuss about Bootstrap. Is it clear? All these things we'll try to cover. Actually, these all we will keep at the end. Order is important. Okay, now. So if you want to get any material related to Angular or anything, just join to my Facebook group, facebook.com/group/worldofangular. Just you join in this group so that if you want to get any more material or any doubts, we can clarify here. Okay, that's it. For more videos, try to subscribe to my channel. Have a nice day. Fine. Bye.